Calculation of rain attenuation for higher frequencies. So when we go up high frequencies, there is a significant attenuation because of rain. So whenever we are talking about some satellite link or communication link or any say wireless communication, then we need to think about rain attenuation whenever we go to higher frequencies. So attenuation implies decrease in signal amplitude. Whenever there is a transmit or receive, then there are in between the clouds. So cloud, fog, they all add up for various type of, you can say, attenuation. But rain is very important, as because the droplets, they fall like this, horizontally polarized, you can say, component of the signal will be lost. The wave can either be absorbed some part or maybe scattered. So all these add up to attenuation because of rain. The statement of this issue is, why higher frequency band? When we are on kilohertz or megahertz, then we don't have to worry much about the rain attenuation. But whenever we are going, say, beyond 10 gigahertz, then because the frequency is getting so less, the frequency is so high, then there will be rain attenuation. The shapes of raindrops, when we compute values, we think it to be somewhat the spherical shape. We'll not take it as ellipse or any other shape. And the wave propagate through the volume of rain, as it goes, the intensity would decline. It will decay. And each drop contributions are independent of the other drops. And then the contribution shall be additive. Let me tell you that the computation of rain attenuation is statistical, not deterministic. So there are statistics of 1 year, 2 year, 5 year. There are various things involved, like the rain rate, etc. And these are taken with K and alpha value. These K and alpha are the regression values. So these are all statistical values. There are certain terminology that you will come across: specific attenuation, exceedance probability, slant path length, horizontal reduction factor, and vertical adjustment factor. So this is a very simple formula for, actually it is by ITU, International Telecommunication Union. So the attenuation is computed in terms of decibel or dB per kilometer, and specific attenuation is obtained from the rain rate. Rain rate is simply the rain that is in millimeter per hour. And this rain rate data, because it is statistical, is available for us. And the region of Earth is divided into various, you can say, regions, categories. So they are being labeled with an alphabet. The place where you are talking about, it may be different place. The other place may be different. So depending upon, say, A, K, J, that rain rate you can find out. It is statistical and it is already been done by people. So ITU rain model just says that this rain attenuation in dB is simply specific attenuation multiplied by the effective path length. Here we have A as attenuation, K and alpha regression coefficient, and R, this is the rain rate. So this K and alpha you just saw is also available to us. Means nothing you have to worry about. Frequency from 1 to 10 gigahertz is given here. You can interpolate and you can go up to, this is also available up to 50 hertz, 60 hertz. And in between, if you want, say 2.7, you say here, then you can always interpolate these values. KH is, because you know we have horizontal as well as vertical component. So KH, KV, the K horizontal and vertical component, alpha horizontal and vertical component. See, they are very specific. These are values. If you see at 1 gigahertz, it's very less. But as you go along, means to higher frequencies, K and alpha, it increases. So what is the procedure? See, this is the antenna. So say it is at some height H1. I'm just taking some example from the mean sea level. And then this is the freezing line or a melting line. Here this signal is passing. This distance is say H2. So what will be this distance from this point to this point? This will be H2 minus H1. H2 is total distance. Say H1 is like this. Say H1 is this. So this will be H2 minus H1. And then we'll use the sine formula. Sine, this is the elevation angle, theta. Sine theta is what? Perpendicular by hypotenuse. Perpendicular is H2 by H2. Sine theta is H2 minus H1 by this slant height. This is the calculation of slant path length. Slant path length is this one. So this is, say, L. You can say LS or LE, whatever. So means, whatever subscript you want to give. Now, this LS is simply equal to, or LE will be equal to H2 minus H1 by sine theta. This is how we find out the slant. Then you have to take the horizontal projection, then horizontal reduction factor, vertical adjustment factor. This all is given in your ITU recommendation. Effective path length can be computed by multiplying of these two, horizontal projection and vertical adjustment factor, these two. So you get an effective path length also. So let us take, I'll just give you a glimpse because I'm not going to into detail. I'm just giving you an idea. The person who is going to compute rain attenuation, he should understand all these things. Rain rate, say we have this much millimeter per hour, elevation angle is this, latitude of earth station is this, and rain height is this. So there are certain results. Means when we talk about variation of regression coefficient k with the frequency, then this is the variation. As you go up to the frequency, you see how this k varies. Then here is the variation of alpha. This is alpha. When you go, means increase the frequency, then this is how the thing vary. Then we have the specific attenuation. The specific attenuation with frequency. So the with frequency, the attenuation increases. Then we have effective path length versus frequency. So effective path length now decreases as the frequency increases. So that is why we have to, we will not go with path length, but effective path length. And then finally, total attenuation, that is dB per kilometer, we find out versus frequency. If you see, if you go from this point to this point, it is almost still, but it goes like this as we go up the frequency. These are attenuation for different accidents probability. That is, if somebody says that I want my link to be 99.99% available for me. For that, we have different 0.5%, 0.01%, 1%. These are the attenuation profile for different, this you can say probability value or accidents value. So what do we conclude here? At high frequency, the effect of rain is very severe. We have to compute this. We cannot just subtract EIRP plus say antenna gain minus the free space loss. We have to subtract the rain attenuation also. You can leave the fog, etc., but rain attenuation is substantial, is significant. For 24 hours signal availability, effective rain fade mitigation technique should be implemented, but always mitigation technique will come with some cost for the resources extra being employed. So this was just a basic idea about if anyone wants to do rain attenuation and one has to do it, this is how he has to go, or you have to go. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.